The circus is in town. In fact, in Grand Island, it's there every day. Fred Churritt passed away in early 2016, but his display and his legacy lives on as people stop every day to enjoy his creations. In this segment of Guide to the Good Life, NTV's Brian Ganuzzi tells us about the man behind Fred's Flying Circus.
The day I came to see the Flying Circus, they were putting the finishing touches on the last edition that Fred had worked on. It was a minion they aptly named Fred. This entire display, believe it or not, started from Fred watching a movie recommended by his great-grandson, Jordan.
He's seen the movie Cars. He got an inspiration from that to build this wrecker. That was the first one he put up. And then it became, instead of Mater, he came up with this Peppermint Kid because he liked peppermint sticks. And one day he was eating one, he's like, well, I'll just call it Peppermint Kid.
So that was the first one, and his family and friends thought maybe that would be it.
But then he came up with an idea to build another one, and then he decided, you know, hey, I should have been doing this years ago, and just kept going.
He then made a Model T car with Shrek and a witch, a Studebaker police car, a wolf car, a devil car, the purple people eater vehicle, and many others. There's still yet another one, though, his daughter Karen said he gave to the Grand Island Humane Society.
Out of all the cars that he made, that was one of his favorites, because he had lost his dog Buddy, and on the back of the license plate it said Buddy.
And it seemed like he'd have one done, almost done, and he'd be working, starting another one. He'd go out of town every weekend to go eat somewhere, and sometimes he'd just drive by a place and see something, or he'd go to an auction, or even he had a couple of them that friends just brought over.
All of these vehicles and the concrete or steel characters were made in just about 8 years, starting in 2009 up till when he passed. Nearly every week, though, since, someone stops by to ask questions about this very unusual scene.
We had people all over the United States. We've had tour. In fact, we had some from South Dakota yesterday, some from Atlanta, Georgia, and someplace else stopping to look. When he was alive and people would come down, oh, it was just his pride and joy to go show them all the stuff and what he was working on.
These days, they almost always stop working and make time to tell Fred's story to those that stop by.
One day I was talking to him, and because he couldn't actually sit and draw an actual picture, because he couldn't do that, he didn't consider himself an artist. And he was telling me that one day, and I go, Fred, look around, this is art. I mean, not just anybody could do this.
Keith helped Fred paint many of the vehicles through the years and is proud of what he describes as just a small part of Fred's Flying Circus.
I like them all. I think they're all cool. Fred loved this place. This was his whole life. He always said that. He was a good guy. Still miss him today.
Brian Ganuzzi, NTV News at Fred's Flying Circus in Grand Island.
You're welcome to stop by the GI Body Shop and Fred's Flying Circus location on East 4th Street in Grand Island. The owners ask that you call ahead, though, if you're bringing a large group.